Good morning. Welcome to Mornings with Zizi. I'm Zizi. Today I would like to talk to you about a topic that's very dear to my heart. And that is, I would like to talk to you about Jean Vanier, the man who really helped change my life. In addition to Helen Keller, he's the second person I would say. Jean Vanier is a very prominent figure in Canada. He is the son of the 19th Governor General. He has a philosophy degree, a PhD in philosophy. He worked all his life for persons with developmental disabilities. His story was that once visited one of the institutions where some of the developmentally disabled were living, and he was horrified by the way they lived. They had no life, and they were without control, without anything that would make them happy. So before he left, he asked to take two of them to live with him. And he found a broken home, some, you know, very old house in France. And he took those two people and they lived together. And this movement that he started became known as L'Arche. And that is the beginning of where this man put all his words into action. Like, how can one man change the whole movement for persons with developmental disabilities? He has such homes in which able-bodied and able-minded people live together with those with developmental disabilities, not just to live together or to help them, but to learn themselves, to learn from them love, to learn from them the human qualities. And as he says, it's the school of love where the able-bodied people learn from those with developmental disabilities how to be happy, how to love, how to communicate at levels that none of us, even the richest, can experience. So he has now like about 34 countries that have these large communities and has been so successful. He started it in 1964. And then in 1971, he co-founded with Mary Matthew, another person in homes also for the developmentally disabled over 80 countries. So he has been known for this kind of thing. But the interesting thing is the first time that I met him, he was giving a lecture about what he's doing. And he talked about how he learned how to be human, how to be vulnerable, how to be prone to do things that we always question and don't like. Like he mentioned once the incident of one of the boys tried to hit him, so he found himself almost coming back to hit him back, and he stopped himself. And he said, I really recognize that I have a black hole inside of me like everybody else. I'm capable of evil as much as I'm capable of love. Although his entire life he's been living with those people until his death, in May of this year. And he has so many workers, a lot of them work as volunteers, some of them get paid, but the whole intention is that they love each other, they live with each other, not as a counselor and a sick person or a person with a disability. They live as equals, and each one helps in his own way, and they understand each other, they listen to each other, they hold each other, they touch each other, and they exchange love. Like for him, he says, like Aristotle and all these people, Edgar Allan Poe, everybody believes that we are motivated by wanting to be happy. We don't do anything just for the thing itself. I think the intention is in the long run that we become happy. And he felt that true happiness was to find yourself, to find that you're human, to find that you're capable of love, since love is the most powerful force. And he said that, like other researchers, found that it's the lack of control that people, whoever that person is, whether it's a mental disability, whatever, it's this lack of control. They did a study on people in institutions, and they had people go in there and give them independence and work with them. And the ones who had the highest kind of involvement, and they gave them the power to control their lives and make decisions, after the experiment was over, they found, I think 40% of them died, because they found that when you have no control, you don't want to live. Just like you seek love and you seek happiness, you also want to have some control over your life. And unfortunately, in institutions, there's no such thing. Everything is managed for the full extent of controlling the every action of those people. They wake up and sleep according to what staff have to do. So anyway, I thought I'd share with you, and I think you wonder sometimes, I was talking to someone yesterday, I said, what can one person do anyway? Well, we have an example of Jean Vanier, one person, and he changed the lives of so many thousands of people over so many years, from 64 until now. So I feel he's been a motivating factor for me to get up and do something, not just talk about it. Love you all, and thank you for coming and listening. Love you. Thank you.